can see, flight was very imperfect before the start of the 20th century. It wasn't until the development of the first plane in 1903 by the Wright brothers that there became significant advancements in the aerospace engineering field. In the 1920s, Robert H. Goddard developed, built, and flew the first successful liquid propellant rocket in 1926. In this discovery, Goddard proved that flight was possible at speeds greater than the speed of sound, and that rockets could work in a vacuum. Major breakthrough in rocket development came in 1938 when James Hart Wild designed, built, and tested the first U.S.-cooled liquid rocket engine. In 1947, this rocket engine powered the first supersonic research aircraft.
The aerospace engineering field continued to see many significant advancements as the 1900s slowly progressed. Rockets, missiles, satellites, and planes all became a huge part of everyday society. With all of these new inventions, the aerospace engineering field started to see a clear structure. Today, aerospace engineers design, analyze, model, simulate, and test aircrafts, spacecrafts, satellites, missiles, rockets, and many other modern-day utilities. Testing, and most of the work done in this field, is done in teams. Each member must specify in their own branch and work together to make the safest and most effective aircraft possible. Planes must be constantly tested for atmospheric pressure, temperature, heavy structural load, and many other systems tests. Now you will see a demonstration of aerodynamics and flight.
When the airplane is in motion, air rushes past the wing. The air passing the upper surface moves a longer distance in the same time as the air passing the lower surface, and therefore moves past the upper surface faster. This difference in air speed increases as the airplane itself moves faster and creates a partial vacuum along the upper wing surface. The normal air pressure under the wing lifts it into this partial vacuum, which enables the airplane to fly.
Today, the aerospace engineering field is looking towards the sky with a higher interest in space. Now engineers are trying to develop passenger spaceships and travel to places we have never gone before. Many graduates from the aerospace engineering program may go to work for companies such as NASA, Boeing, the Air Force, and Lockheed Martin. As we continue to see more and more advancements in this field, we can only imagine what the future has in store for aerospace engineering.